In today's video, we're gonna be comparing dropshipping to reselling. What is going on YouTube? My name is Arabelle, and if you're brand new, welcome. On this channel, we talk about reselling, side hustles, and theme page content. If you haven't already, go ahead and smash the subscribe button. So let's go ahead and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any future uploads. With that out of the way, let's get right into today's video. This is a question I get asked a lot, and that question is, hey Arabelle, should I start reselling or should I start dropshipping? And well, because I've been asked this question way too many times, and I want to just make this video out there, and hopefully you, the viewer, can decide for yourself if you should start, you know, reselling or you start dropshipping, because, you know, either you saw that a lot of people you know or a lot of people online are making quite a bit of money doing this. But before we get even into the pros and cons, for those of you who have no idea what in the world I'm talking about and you decided to click a random video, well, let's break it down just for you guys. Now, because I am a reseller part-time, I also have tried dropshipping, which is why, you know, I decided to make this video, because I have done both, definitely had way more success reselling. But yeah, let's go ahead and just break down what on earth is Shopify dropshipping. Well, starting off, you know, you're going to need to find a product from either Alibaba or AliExpress slash a distributor from China, because usually the cheapest way to get it. You're not going to buy any of the product, but you just want to find a winning product. After you found that product, you're going to want to go ahead, go to Shopify, create a store around that product. Now, once you've made the store, you want to, of course, make some ads. Either you can pay for a service to do that, you can pay someone to do that, or you can make them yourself. Now, after you've made the ads, you're going to go on Instagram. You're going to find theme pages. You're going to find influencers. You're going to talk to them. You're going to DM them. Ask them for rates. After they give you rates, you decide which ones you want to work with. After you've done that, you go ahead, you send them the ads, you pay them, and they will simply leave a link in bio or a swipe up on their story. Those are the two most common ones. As well as they'll post whatever ad you sent them on their story and their feed. And then from there, that's you're going to end up converting customers. You can also go on Facebook ads and try to do it like that. It is definitely a bit more riskier. And it does take a little bit more knowledge than the, you know, just the easier way and cheaper way by simply going through Instagram. But yeah, after you've done that, all you have to do is you got to wait for people to buy your product. After they buy it, you're going to go ahead, you're going to take their address, and basically you're going to put that into AliExpress or Alibaba. And that's where you're going to end up sending the product from the distributor to the customer. You're basically the middleman. But luckily, there are tools on Shopify that allow this process to be automated. And yeah, there is a lot of free videos and tutorials showing you how to do all this stuff. This is just basic, just a basic overview of how, like, everything works. I'm by no means a guru. I've only done, like, Shopify dropshipping one or two times, but that's basically the map. That's basically how it works. There's, of course, a lot more complicated, like, of how to make a website, how to do Facebook ads, how to find the right pages to work with. Of course, how to find a winning product, because, you know, without a winning product, how are you going to sell that product? But of course, even if you have a good product, you don't have good ads. Basically, there's a lot of pieces of the puzzle that have to fit together so that everything works out and you end up making a lot of money. And that's basically it. Like I already said, it gets a bit more complicated than that. But yeah, that's a good overview. And for those of you who also have no idea what reselling is, or you have some sort of idea, I'm going to go ahead and quickly break that down for you as well. eBay reselling is definitely a lot more simple. Basically, what you're going to go do is you're going to go to garage sales. You're going to go to your thrift stores, if that, you know, that being Savers, Goodwill, Value Village, whatever you have around. You're going to find products there. You're going to go ahead, once you find a product that you think might do well, you're going to go ahead and open up the eBay app. Find some comps on it. You're going to see what it's selling for, see how many have sold, see if that profit margin is good enough for you. And after you made that decision, you're going to go ahead and buy it. You're going to go home. If the product needs some sort of testing or cleaning, you're going to go ahead and do that. After that's done, you're going to take some pictures, list it up on eBay. Once it sells, all you have to do is ship it out to the buyer. And that's it. That's as far as it goes. It's definitely a way more simple process. You know, all the promoting of the product is done through eBay, and eBay does that for you. That is basically a good overview of both. Now let's go into the pros and cons of each, because even though, you know, they both sound super interesting and they both sound like something you might want to do, maybe these are stuff that you want to consider Let's go ahead and go into the pros of Shopify dropshipping. Well, starting off, everything is on online, which means there's no need to store inventory. All you need is a computer, a phone, a laptop. Any of that will do you good. And yeah, that's all you need. It's basically, that's all you need to run an entire operation. On top of that, it can be extremely profitable. As long as you find a winning product, you can make a lot of money, okay? The amount of people that buy stuff through just seeing ads on Instagram is insane. So, you know, as long as you find a product that can be scaled up and that can make you a lot of money, you can make a lot of money. I'm not joking. There's people out there. I'm not talking about, you know, the gurus trying to, you know, flex on you and trying to, you know, get you to buy the course, but I mean genuine people who have done this and have had a lot of success. On top of that, you know, if you do make it to that very profitable stage, you can make this completely passive. What I mean by that is you can basically become a quote-unquote distributor of the product yourself, hire employees to do all the work for you, and you're gonna have basically a company and a proper business. And you won't have to do any of the work. You'll just be kind of quote-unquote overseeing everything because you can just hire people out to do the work for you. And those are, I think, all the pros that I can think up of. Of course, there's a lot more I'm sure other people can't think up of. Those are the major ones that I'm thinking of right now. But let's go into the cons, because as good as it sounds, there's also a lot of bad things that I can say about Shopify dropshipping. So let's get started. Now, starting off, you're going to need around $150 to $200, depending on how many products you want to promote. What I mean by that is you can make a like multi-product store, you can make a singular product store, and you know, for each product they want to promote, you're going to need to make ads, and you're going to need to pay for a Shopify store, you're going to need to pay for domain, you're going to need to pay for, you know, if you're paying people to make your ads, like I already said, you're going to need to pay those theme pages. So it's going to cost you around $150 to $200 just to get started. And for somebody who's just like, yeah, but what if it doesn't work out? There you go. That leads me to my next point. You have to find a winning product. It's incredibly difficult. Of course, there's services out there that can, you know, that can help you, that can kind of guide you to find a winning product. It's not guaranteed it's going to work out. It's very risky is what I'm trying to say. So do be careful when you're trying to do this. You know, make sure you have the money to spend. That's basically the biggest cons of Shopify dropshipping. But let's go ahead and move on to the pros of eBay reselling. Well, starting off, unlike dropshipping, you don't need any money to get started. You can simply sell stuff you already have at home. If that's video games, that's shoes, that's clothes, you can use that to get you started. On top of that, unlike Shopify, where you need to actually build a store, eBay is fairly easy to use. You know, listing items, they made it super convenient for even a beginner to get started. And yeah, you know, as you begin to grow your store, as you list more, you can of course, you know, use more features to your advantage. But yeah, eBay, the entire platform is super easy to use, which is definitely a big pro. On top of that, this can also be scaled up to something that can make you, you know, like six figures a year, you know, around that $100,000 a year range. Definitely, you're gonna need to be doing this full time. But at the end of the day, if you really enjoy this, especially if you're, you know, making content as well, and YouTube's also bringing that revenue, boom, you can easily scale this up to be something next level. Yeah, well, of course, as good as that might sound, there is also cons. eBay fees. Don't get me started on those. Piss me off so much. Of course, if you do decide to pay for a store, eBay fees do lower, but do make sure you have the sales to do that. On top of that, dealing with customers on eBay. Oh my God, some people are just ridiculous. It's my favorite one is, actually, I'll throw up the TikTok right now. Destination unknown as we're pulling for some gas. Officially placed a poster reveals a smile from the pack. Elephants and acrobats, lions, snakes, monkey. Village beats righteous, sister Cena says funky. How bizarre. How bizarre, how bizarre. If you get the joke, you know what I'm talking about because you're probably a reseller. But people love to open cases because the product or the, you know, the item they bought hasn't exactly arrived and it's been a day late, and then they'll close it like 10 minutes later because it just arrived at the door. This happens about like 2-3 times a month, and it is It's kind of getting stressful, but it's also hilarious because people just freak out. You know, to add to that, you know, making sure that your store has all positive reviews, make sure you have no negative, no neutral reviews. That can get kind of stressful because you're dealing with a lot of people, and people these days are super picky, especially, like I said, if the package doesn't work or if the item system doesn't work, you have to refund them because eBay, you know, the customer's always right, and eBay does kind of tend to lean towards the buyer's direction. And I think one other con that I do want to add is you have to store inventory. You need space to store inventory. I've been making a video about this on how to, you know, start some sort of inventory system. But even for me, in my tiny little studio office that I got going on here, especially because it's in my bedroom, I don't have a lot of space to store stuff. But I am doing, you know, I am making the best of what I got. And there's definitely ways to work around this, but do make sure you do have the space if you want to scale this up to a full-time store or a full-time gig. And with the pros and cons out of the way for both, let's kind of conclude the video with hopefully what I think you should consider when, you know, going between both. If you want to become a Shopify dropshipper, that probably means you're somebody who doesn't want to go out and find inventory. It's not something you want to enjoy doing. You know, you're somebody who likes to just make websites, you know, social media marketing, you know how to make ads, you know what products are going to work, you just know a lot about that niche. So I definitely recommend you do that. On top of that, you're probably someone who has the money to actually, you know, try out different products and try out different things. So if that sounds like you, I would recommend it. I would also recommend doing a little bit more research, you know, after you do watch this video, if that's something you're interested in. But you know, if that doesn't sound like you, and you know, maybe you're a reseller, maybe, you know, you enjoy going out and finding, you know, one or two products a day from, you know, Goodwill or Value Village, and you enjoy listing items on eBay, and you know, maybe you don't necessarily enjoy, but you don't mind dealing with customers. You don't have a big budget to start off with. It is a pandemic. We are, you know, in tough times, but you just want to make a little bit of money on the side. You know, maybe you're more of a reseller than a dropshipper. Now, hopefully this video kind of answered the questions you had. I'm not going to go into any more further detail or confuse you anymore than I already have, but hopefully you have an idea of what you want to start. If not now, the beginning of 2021, it's never too late to start. There's always going to be tutorials out there. There's going to always be more new and updated information. Now, with that being said, let's go ahead and wrap up the video. I do wish every single one of you a happy holidays, hopefully celebrating it with your family and friends. I also do wish you a happy New Year's. I won't stop uploading videos every single Wednesday and Sunday at 4 p.m. sharp. So if you have nothing to do and you want to learn a little bit more about what's going on in my reselling operation, or if you want to learn about some sort of other side hustles or theme page content, make sure you go ahead and hit the subscribe button, hit that bell notification bell so you don't miss out on any future uploads. Of course, make sure you go ahead and hit that like button. Hit me up on TikTok. We just reached 1,300 followers there. Thank you for the support on this channel. Thank you for the support on my TikTok. Without a further continuation of this video, peace out.